This, and any other BNT videos are not made, and or produced specifically for children under the age of 13.
As you can see, I've already been doing some air brushing. Let's wait. Yeah, that was the pump. Anyway, I've been doing some air brushing, as you can see. What I'm doing is I'm giving it a small thin layer of some very light gray. I'm trying to simulate by only spraying on the panels, thus creating some sort of a pre-shade effect. That's not that easy because the panels are very small. Now when that is dry, I go over it again with a very light spray of the same color to blend those colors back into one. And after that, there is another step. Actually, there are, let's see, one, two, three, four, five steps. So, as I said, the first step will be trying to hit every single panel individually as much as possible, and that thus creating a slight pre-shade effect. So that is step one. Right, the next layer we're gonna do, and that is a small wash layer. When I say small wash layer, I actually mean very, very, very thin wash. In order to do that, I'm gonna first make sure that I put a lot of water on the point where I'm gonna put the wash on. I'm gonna do it in several steps, because otherwise it's gonna be dry before I start the wash itself. And dip it very lightly in dark gray. As you can see, it is actually a very little amount of wash. It is only to creep in the nooks and crannies, but only very, very minute. A little bit more over here, perhaps. And before the water, which is being used for the wash, is completely dry, I am going to use a Q-tip, which I'm going to show you in a few seconds, and wipe away the wash, but only on the higher or the upper layers of the model. And what I mean is, you can see this over here, so that's washed, and the top of this circle is washed, and a few details over here as well. So that is what I mean when I say the upper areas of the details of the model. So we're going to go all over the model with the minute wash. That's layer number two. Another layer. I have mixed some of the base color with some white, and I'm gonna spray a light coat over the surfaces, that is to say the surfaces which are higher up. So in case of the bridge section or the front, a very light coat, as you can see, on the raised surfaces. And if I would be making it too light, I can just use the standard color, the standard base color again, to blend it in. So I'm going to continue all over the Falcon. Continue all over the Galactica, preparing that white coat. And that's layer number three. Or four, where was I? I believe three. Next layer. We're going to use, in this case, Pledge Revive Floor Gloss, which is of course a varnish. It's a bit thick. We're gonna put a layer on it to protect the paint. Now it's gonna make the Galactica shiny, which of course is not what we want, but it will protect the paint. Let me get rid of the cable. And it will also help me to place the decals. And I will consider the decals not a layer. But as I said, it made the Galactica shiny. And yeah, that means the final layer after we install the decals is going to be getting the Galactica dull again, so using a flat coat. For some reason this airbrush is not working along with me. I have to clean this one again. Anyway, I will not bother you with cleaning my airbrush, because that is a task which I really, really don't like. But because especially these ones are not working with me, I must say, the last couple of weeks. I try to clean them every time, thoroughly, by fully disassembling them and cleaning them and cleaning them and cleaning them, but to no avail. See, it keeps bubbling. That's a problem for later. I'm gonna keep on putting some protective layer on the Galactica, and we'll come back with the decals later. Okay, I have sprayed it with the Future Shine, or the what was it called? The Revive It Floor Polish. It's ready for the decals. But before I'm going to do the decals, there's something else I want to do first. This is the original metal rod on which the Galactica, let me turn it over gently, on which the Galactica is supposed to be put on. Now, there's also already some glue over here because I've tried something else that failed. And the other side, hold on, of the display is, or the base is this, so this rod goes in here and the other side goes in the hole of the Galactica. However, this of course is solid metal, and these are cables, so that's not going to work. So what I found, to my surprise, in a local discount store are these reusable straws, stainless steel, and as far as I could gather, they are actually the exact same diameter, or maybe a smidge smaller, than the original stand. And let's test that with the base. It's a bit smaller, but it's hardly noticeable. With a bit of glue I could stick it in. So, but it's, of course, it's far too long. I have to cut it. Now what I can do is, of course, I cut it, I can get it in the same size as the base, as the original stand. However, apart from this stand, we're gonna have to put another stand underneath, a wooden base for the batteries. So it's gonna be longer, this rod. So what I'm thinking of is just cutting it in half. There is a decorative strips on here. Can you see it? Let me see if you can zoom in. Maybe you can see it. There's some decorative strips. Ah, there you can see it now. I intend to use these, so I'm going to cut it halfway around here with a knife, with a saw, and I believe that this is thick enough for the cable to go through, and that would then allow me to put the Galactica on its stand. But before I do that, let's first cut this thing in half, and of course I still need to add the decals. And while it's upside down, let me see if I can remove a bit of that glue which I tried earlier. I tried a plastic stand earlier, but that was too small and it didn't fit, and it was so thin, the plastic, that it actually was leaning over. So I need to clean up this mess and probably do a quick repainting of the base color. Although you're not actually going to see this part, of course, of the Galactica. Of course, be careful that not cut through the cable, otherwise I'm in a lot of trouble. Yeah, that's gonna work. That will work. Okay, yeah, I can remove that glue. So, that it will be a next point. So, let's start using a saw and saw the straw in half. Oh, by the way, these were only 1 euro. 4 of them. Good deal, eh? Yes. Decal time. So, I have placed a tub of hot water. I got a water cooker nearby. I have two of the first decals I'm going to do, so I put them both in the water. Now I need to find a tweezer, because I'm not going to burn my hands trying to get them out again. Okay, I'm going to take a jar of paint, and I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do with the jar of paint later on. Is it in picture? No, it isn't in picture. Okay, hold on. Okay, so let me get the first one out. Because the water is hot, it's probably already loose. So, and let me put them on this type of paint. You can still can't see it, and I've just dropped it. Hold on. Let me put it closer to the camera. That's better. Okay. Is that better? That's better. Okay, let's get the other one out as well. Okay. And we have over here a cup. The cap of the Microsol decal solution. I'm using the cap because if I'm using the entire bottle and the bottle might fall over, then I am screwed. And when the cap only falls over, then at least I'm only lost that small piece, and actually it's much more stable. So I'm going to put some of that Microsol solution stuff on the areas where the decals are going to go. This was the first I had, and I wonder which... No, this one. So, let's get them out. Okay, let's use a knife to make sure it's in the right position. Yes. And let's put on the second one before this one dries. I'm going to replace them, re-edit the position. Oh, this is already in okay. I'm going to take a cut and swap and I'm going to wipe away all the water below underneath this decal and try to maneuver a bit so it's in a better position and it conforms to the shape below. Okay, now as soon as it is in the correct position, I'm going to add another bit of that Microsol, and the idea behind that is that it will soften up the decal, that it will actually conform to the surface below, so all the details below it. And I need to let that dry, air dry as much as possible. Let's make sure that this goes around. Should have cut off the film over there on the sides, but when it's dry I can just cut it off by hand. Let me replace it a little bit. That's better. Yes, now it actually goes to the edge. Yes, and that's okay. So I'm going to continue on the rest of the decals and let it dry thoroughly before I'm going to add layer 5, which is going to be, of course, the dull coat. I hit a small snag. Now, I've built this model before, but I can't recall if I had the same problem the first time. It's the rear sections on the instruction manual. Let's show you where I'm talking about. These over here. Now, I installed the one in the front. That's no problem. That's number 7. These say we have to install decal number 10. But when we look at decal sheet, I just used number 10. This was 10A. This is 10A and 10B. It doesn't say where 10A and 10B are supposed to come. Besides that, I have installed 2 of the decals at the moment. I have installed A and B. and they don't fit. They fit over here on the top, as you can see, and then wrap around, but they don't end up over here. And I tried on the other side, if maybe this should go on that side. It doesn't make any difference. They are too short. So what I'm doing is, I am installing them like this, so you can see them on the top and the side. And on the bottom, I will have to use red paint to finish up the line. It's really weird that not only are these not corresponding to the decal sheet on the instructions, A and B, they're too short. They could have easily, it doesn't affect where A and B are supposed to come. So, that's a bit of a downer. What we'll have to model on, and let's hope that the rest of the decals all are the correct size. I'm using an old photo frame. I buy these photo frames at the Goodwill store. This was about 1 euro. So I take out the back plate, and this is the passepartout, I think it is, and this was the sheet where it came. These are all going to be thrown away. However, I'm going to keep this one, because that one will act as a template for a piece of MDF, which you're going to use 4mm MDF, or maybe even a bit of other material, but wood at least, which is going to be put in painted black, and that is going to be the base for the Galactica. I have also cut out a few holes in here, as you can see, and with a hammer yanked in these two switches. I have to use two switches, unfortunately. I've got two batteries. There you are. Got two battery holders for the 9-volt blocks. Those are going to be fixed on the bottom of the MDF plate. Talk about the Galactica. The decals are all on now. I have added some flat coat on it. Looks good. I did have a problem, as I said, with the markers. No, not in front. In the back. So I used some red paint. You can unfortunately see it. Some red paint to finish up the sections which didn't fit. There's one area over here I can see. I have to repair the paint damage over on the bottom. And I have to spray a little bit more of the flat coat on the side. And this actually didn't really work that well, the side of the red markers. When then all that is finished, then I can cut off the fiber optics on the side. I want to wait with that till the very last. There's one thing else I need to take care of, and that is the back. As you can see, maybe this is the better air angle, yes. We have here the back side of the Galactica. Can you see it? Yes, you can see it. Let me put in a battery. Let me show you what, if I can find the battery. I had a battery over here. Hold on. There was a battery this morning. Oh yes, there it is. So, let me show you what happens if I turn on the light of this, of the engine. Let's hope it's the right, yes, it's the right cable. What you can see in this angle over here, that you can actually see the LEDs. That was, of course, expected. So what I need to do is put a piece of paper in front of the LEDs so they will diffuse. And luckily, I still have not glued in this part. This actually has got... Oh, I can see what happened here. The blue paint must have dripped all the way through and damaged this part. Damaged this part, so I have to repaint this bugger. Actually the rest of the blue didn't came through as well. I'm probably gonna remove, I'm gonna remove all these. These are not gonna work anyway. So I have to repaint this. The blue LEDs will take care of everything, and I put in a red piece of plastic and the back. It's not gonna work, but anyway, so that is the plan. So what I need to do is, unfortunately, repaint this, the back section. Not only repaint it, but also, of course, use the wash and so forth. and then put a diffuser behind the engine plates to diffuse the two LEDs. Work continues on the base for the Galactica. As you can see, I have glued everything in now. The two battery packs are glued in. I've got, let me put this on the side, I have yanked in or pushed in two switches. Unfortunately, as I said, I have to use two switches for two batteries, but that's the way it is. The blacks are already connected to the switch, and there's a reason for that. The top section looks ghastly at the moment, but that's gonna change pretty soon. The original display base section had already been glued in, but that also doesn't look good, but that's also gonna change. And what I'm gonna do, first of all, I'm gonna use hot glue, and I'm gonna make a seal around here on the inside of the wood that is inside the frame. It's not gonna be coming out anymore, so that's not a real problem. And the reason I'm gonna make that seal is because I have here some resin, two components resin, polyester resin, which I added a few drops of gloss black and metallic blue in there. I used Tamiya acrylic paints for that, and I'm now going to pour this resin over the base, making sure that I'm not going to spill, of course, onto the plastic circle base. And that might work, actually give me a very glossy and very shiny and very smooth finish. I might put another layer on it later with some additional colors, but this takes a long time to dry, so that's what I do. Well, let's make sure that I spilled a bit on the wood. Okay, so let's make sure that there's every nook and cranny. So I have glued in the display on the base. Used several layers of liquid latex, as you can see, but the last layer of latex had a problem. It didn't dry correctly. So what I did, I removed a bit of that latex and then replaced it with this. This is realistic water. It's almost the same thing as that liquid latex. Resin. This actually does the same thing. It looks the same, but this is you don't need to mix it. This is ready to go. So about two or three thin layers, and that finally dried up. Now it does look like a bit like water. That's unfortunate, but at least it's smooth, and you can see the colors vibrating through it. I use also some gold chrome spray, decanted a bit, and used a simple brush and brushed on the letters and the details of the display base set. Now, before I'm going to glue in the Galactica, I need to step off all the fiber optics, because if I don't, I run the risk of them falling onto the surface, and it's not 100% dry yet. So I'm going to do that first and then glue in this base pole into the hole of the base and then connect all the cables. There's also one thing I need to do still before I forget. I need to fix the back section, because it's you can still see the LEDs poking out when the lights are on. So I'm probably gonna glue in on the back. Oh, there we are. Glue in the back a or on over here actually a piece of styrene sheet. But as I said, let's start snipping off. And someone asked, won't you get in trouble with the ravine between those two pieces? And then I said, we'll come to that bridge when we get to it. So let me quickly snap off a few of these over here using a very sharp cutter. And that's it. Now, maybe a quick demonstration of how it looks when I've cut off the... I was hoping to find my battery over here so I can demonstrate it. Let me check a look if I can find the battery. Hold on. Okay, let me try it to demonstrate this light. I believe it's this one over here. Let's see, green and red. Yes, so let me show you and see. Now you can actually see the lights poking out through the plastic, the model. So we're gonna cut off all the other fiber optic strands and then glue on the model onto the base. Oh, sorry, glue on the model onto the base. Okay, I have cut off all the fiber optics, as you can see, and I have glued it onto the display stand. It's still not 100% locked, but it's slow drying two components, a polyester glue, so that's going to take at least a day. Now, about the problem with the rear, I have actually done something else. As you can see, I've put in some cotton, and I still need to glue this in, of course, but when I switch on the engine, oh yeah, I still have to glue it in. Engine's now, hold on, there you are. And now we actually have a relatively uniform glow of blue coming from the engines. Let me, there you go. So that's taken care of. Now, talking about the other lights, there they are. And those three fiber optics in the back that were not working, I don't know which one they were because I can't see any fiber optic light currently not working. So they all work. Let's quickly see if we can actually take a look inside the landing base. Hold on. There you are. So the landing base also look perfect with the lights on. So all it takes now, of course, is to zoom out again, is to glue the backside back on, and then she's finished. The Moebius Galactica model kit. So hope you enjoyed this build. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see each other soon for next project.